Here at Forward Leeds, we understand that as students, you may be coming into contact with drugs for the first time. We want to give you some information on those drugs to make sure that if you do decide to take those drugs or to experiment with those drugs, you do so safely.
It may be tempting, but mixing different substances together can be quite risky. It can have potentially dangerous and unpredictable effects. So stick to one substance for the night and stay with that. It's a common myth, but eating definitely is not cheating. Before a big night out, it's a good idea to line your stomach with some good food, but make sure you try and wait an hour or two before actually using any substances to avoid feeling sick. So when you're taking drugs, it's good to start slow. Try with small amounts to start with, like half a pill or just a dab, and wait for the effects to kick in so you know the deal. And it's good to pace yourself, even with alcohol, so give yourself space in between drinking and using drugs as well. It's a good idea to have a game plan before you go out. So make sure your phone's charged, know how you're getting home, and make sure someone you trust knows where you're going to be. It's important at night out to stay hydrated. It can help you to avoid feeling rough the next day as well. So slowly sip no more than a pint of water over an hour. And it's also important to take regular breaks from the dance floor as well so you don't overheat. It's important to stay safe by sticking together. Make sure you've got people around you that you can trust and stay together as well. It's good before you go out to swap numbers, maybe set up a group and set a meet-up point as well. And also check on people who might disappear to make sure they're okay. So if you see someone in trouble, such as having chest pains, difficulty breathing or losing consciousness, make sure you get medical help as fast as you can and make sure someone stays with the person as well. And when the medic gets there, make sure you tell them what the person's used. You won't get in trouble, they're not there to judge, they're just there to help.
Here at Forward Leeds, we work with a variety of drugs. Today we're here to offer you some advice on certain drugs that you may come across in the next few years whilst you're at university. So cannabis is the most common drug you may come across in the next few years whilst you're at university. Also known as pot, weed, hash or dope. Just a bit of weed, just a plant. Hear this quite a lot as a drugs worker. I mean, what's the harm? It grows, you dry it out, you roll it up, you smoke it. No harm done. Not quite the case. By the time this stuff reaches you, it has been bred purposely to be ultra strong and can be the form of depression, anxiety, and even psychosis in young adults today. Cocaine. Cocaine can come in two main forms, a white powder and a small white rock. The white powder can sometimes be called a rich man's drug because it's quite expensive, or it might be associated with Hollywood film stars or the rich and famous. Their addiction can go on for quite a long time before they actually realise that they have an issue. Denial is a massive factor in cocaine addiction because it is more of a psychological addiction than it is a physical addiction, like with other drugs such as heroin. Cocaine is normally taken by snorting it through a rolled up note, which can cause damage to the septum of the nose, as you may have seen with some celebrities over the years. MDMA, ecstasy. This is by far the second most common drug for the age range of 21 to 26 year olds. So what are the dangers of taking ecstasy? Severe dehydration in a busy environment like a nightclub or a festival. Ecstasy can cause the body to release a hormone which stops it producing urine. So drinking more when dehydrated can have a very detrimental effect on the body and it can even result in death. So you may have wondered as you're walking around the streets what the little metal vials, little canisters are. Well, that's actually nitrous oxide, laughing gas to you and me. This can be taken by transferring it to a balloon and then being inhaled. If that is inhaled directly from the canister, it can stop a person breathing as it can cause spasms to the throat. Other drugs you may come across in your time at university are benzodiazepines, such as diazepam, or Xanax. Now, these drugs are more and more being used commonly to come down from other drugs, such as cocaine, MDMA, which is ecstasy, or LSD. Now, these are very, very addictive substances if misused and can cause some very severe withdrawal symptoms. So the last drug I'm going to talk about today is ketamine. Now, you may have all heard the rumours it's a horse tranquilizer, it's used by vets. Ketamine is actually an anaesthetic used by paramedics at the scene of some quite horrendous accidents. If you take too much ketamine, you may enter what is called a K-hole, where it feels like your mind and body have separated. This can be a very scary experience for some people. So the effects of ketamine can be anxiety, stress, depression, and even panic attacks. Long-term use of ketamine can cause it to crystallize within the bladder. So when you go to the loo, you're actually trying to pass crystals. A very, very painful experience.
So it's a good idea to be in a positive mental state before you use any drugs or alcohol, as they can kind of make the effects of any kind of low mood or anxiety worse. So if you're not feeling good, it's maybe a good idea to just give it a rest for a bit. It's really important to use in a safe environment and with people you trust as well, and definitely don't use alone. It can also be handy to have someone around who's not using as well, who can look out for you. And also, don't be pressured into doing anything you don't want to do. Only do what you're comfortable doing. So if you're using drugs that come in powders, make sure they're as finely crushed as possible, and also alternate nostrils as well. It's also really important to not share drug taking equipment, as it can kind of spread bacteria and viruses as well. So before a night out, it can be a good idea to have a plan for how much you're going to use and also when you'll stop. And as well, it's important to take your regular breaks from using drugs and alcohol to allow your body to recover. So some good tips for dealing with come downs and hangovers are to eat some healthy food, get plenty of rest and sleep, and rehydrate as well. Gentle exercise can be helpful sometimes, and making sure you're sticking around people and maybe do something fun, because come downs can make you feel a bit low sometimes. And if you're worried about any of your symptoms, make sure you seek help. So it's important to be aware of the short-term and long-term effects of using drugs. Using substances can have unpleasant effects both kind of during and straight after using drugs, such as nausea and paranoia, and also more long-term effects. So these can be mental health difficulties such as feeling low mood, anxiety, and even psychosis. And also it can have long-term physical impacts as well. Using drugs like cocaine can increase your risk of heart attacks, and with drugs like ketamine you can have issues with like your bladder and stuff. So it's important to kind of be aware of those effects before using them. So drugs and alcohol can lower your inhibitions, so it's really important to not put yourself in risky situations, like going back to random people's houses or kind of going off on your own. So it's important to avoid those kind of situations and make sure there's people there to look out for you who know where you are. So it's important before using drugs to think of the consequences that could happen if you get caught. So this could include legal consequences, but also consequences for university place, your halls of residence, and thinking about your future career as well. So it's always important to not share drug taking equipment or be passing spliffs to keep yourself safe, so you're not spreading viruses and bacteria. And that's even more important nowadays to stop the spread of COVID-19. So we know that as students, things are a lot different now with the pandemic. You maybe can't do the things you normally do, like going out and having parties. But the sooner we all kind of work together and avoid like mingling in households together, the sooner things will get back to normal.
If you would like some more information on anything we've talked about today, please get in touch with us here at Forward Leeds.